This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Book, Mademoiselle Pearl by Guy De Maupassant. Mademoiselle Pearl. 1. What a strange idea it was for me to choose Mademoiselle Pearl for Queen that evening. Every year I celebrate Twelfth Night with my old friend Chantal. My father, who was his most intimate friend, used to take me round there when I was a child. I continued the custom, and I doubtless shall continue it, as long as I live, and as long as there is a Chantal in this world. The Chantals lead a peculiar existence. They live in Paris, as though they were in Grasse, Evitat, or Pont-à-Mousson. They have a house with a little garden near the observatory. They live there, as though they were in the country. Of Paris, the real Paris, they know nothing at all, they suspect nothing, they are so far away. However, from time to time, they take a trip into it. Mademoiselle Chantal goes to lay in her provisions, as it is called in the family. This is how they go to purchase their provisions. Mademoiselle Pearl, who has the keys to the kitchen closet, for the linen closets are administered by the mistress herself. Mademoiselle Pearl gives warning that the supply of sugar is low, that the preserves are giving out, that there is not much left in the bottom of the coffee bag. Thus warned against famine, Mademoiselle Chantal passes everything in review, taking notes on a pad. Then she puts down a lot of figures, and goes through lengthy calculations and long discussions with Mademoiselle Pearl. At last they manage to agree, and they decide upon the quantity of each thing of which they will lay in a 3 months' provision. Sugar, rice, prunes, coffee, preserves, cans of peas, beans, lobster, salt or smoked fish, etc., etc. After which, the day for the purchasing is determined on, and they go in a cab with a railing round the top, and drive to a large grocery store on the other side of the river in the new sections of the town. Madame Chantal and Mademoiselle Pearl make this trip together, mysteriously, and only return at dinner time, tired out, although still excited, and shaken up by the cab, the roof of which is covered with bundles and bags, like an express wagon. For the Chantals, all that part of Paris, situated on the other side of the Seine, constitutes the new quarter, a section inhabited by a strange, noisy population, which cares little for honor, spends its days in dissipation, its nights in revelry, and which throws money out of the windows. From time to time, however, the young girls are taken to the Opera Comique, or the Theatre Francais, when the play is recommended by the paper, which is read by M. Chantal. At present, the young ladies are respectively 19 and 17. They are two pretty girls, tall and fresh, very well brought up, in fact, too well brought up, so much so that they pass by unperceived like two pretty dolls. Never would the idea come to me to pay the slightest attention or to pay court to one of the young Chantal ladies. They are so immaculate that one hardly dares speak to them. One almost feels indecent when bowing to them. As for the father, he is a charming man, well-educated, frank, cordial.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.